Hello everyone, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and safe at your home. Welcome to Madhya English School Online Education. Right now we all are in a class of Standard 1. We are going to learn mathematics. So, my dear tiny students, let's begin our day with a meaningful thought. Thought for the day is, the future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. Yes, my dear students, the word believe, it is most important. You must have faith on your thoughts. If you think that I want to become this and have faith on it, and work on it, and inshallah you will get till your destination. So again I would like to repeat, the future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. So let's start our journey towards learning. Sit straight everyone, make your back straight. So you all are ready to learn? Yes. First of all, take all the essential stationery which you need to write. As I told you that we are going to make revision of chapter number 7 and you all have to copy it in your rough book. If your fair book is incomplete, then you can complete it in your fair book. Okay? Write today's date and day in this corner. As we are doing in every lecture, first of all, write the heading. Look, my dear students, whenever we are going to start our studies, in each and every lecture, it is must that we have to write the heading, so that the connectivity becomes continue and you can understand what you are learning. So write the heading, chapter number 7, subtracting greater numbers, SUBTRACTING, subtracting, GREATER, greater, NUMBERS, numbers. You have to write the heading on this way only. Okay? Completed everyone? Very good. Before we start, let me inform you about learning objectives for chapter number 7. What does it mean by? It means, here is the conclusion what we are going to learn in the whole chapter. In chapter number 7, we are going to learn about counting back to subtract. Addition facts. Subtracting one digit from two digit number. Subtraction using number strip. Double digit subtraction and problem solving. These are the points of which we are going to learn in chapter number 7. Now, here are the learning objectives for today. Means what we are going to learn today. Revision. Before we start new topic, first we will make revision of previous lectures so that if anyone can left yesterday or they were not understand the topic, they can revise it properly. Afterwards, using your addition facts to subtract. Also, today we will learn table of 2. So, you all are ready? What is subtraction? You all might have a question that, ma'am, what is subtraction? What is called subtraction? Or how can we make subtraction? So here is the answer. Subtraction is an arithmetic operation that represents the operation of removing objects from a collection. The result of a subtraction is called a difference. Subtraction is signified by the minus sign. Look, what does it say? That subtraction is an arithmetic operation. You might have heard about the operations which occurs in the body, but this is an arithmetic operation, means mathematics operation, that represent the operation of removing objects from a collection. Subtraction means to remove or cut off the objects from given collection. The result of subtraction is called a difference. At the end, what you get, the answer is called difference. Subtraction is signified by the minus sign. The sign of subtraction is called minus. For example, we can say that 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. This is the sign of subtraction. It is called minus. This is the result, which we called difference. Now let's learn about counting back to subtract. How can we make subtraction? By the method of counting backward. Suppose there were 18 animals watching the race and 3 animals left early. Would they have said that, think in your mind that in a jungle there were 18 animals watching the race. After some time, 3 animals left away early. How many animals were left watching the race? They are asking us the question that if 3 animals left away, then how many animals were left watching the race? Now see, how can we make backward counting? First of all, take the numbers of animals watching the race. There are 18 animals watching the race. 3 left away. So we have to minus or cut off 3. 18 minus 3. Now, start with the bigger number. What does it say? That start with the bigger numbers. So look at the numbers given. 18 and 3. Which number is bigger? It is 18. So keep number 18 in your mind. Start with the bigger number. After that, count back 3 numbers. As we are going to make subtraction, so we have to make backward counting. What is the meaning of backward counting? That we have to count the numbers that comes before given numbers. And we have to back 3 steps. 18 before, 17, 16 and 15. You will reach at 15. 15 is the answer or difference, which we have to write in this column. So our answer is, there were 15 animals left watching the a race. I hope the concept becomes clear and all the students understand how can we make subtraction using counting backward. Yesterday we have completed this exercise also, solved by counting back. If anyone has left to complete the work, they can complete with me right now. First sum is 19 minus 2. So 19 is bigger number, minus 2. Make 2 steps backward counting, you will reach at 17. 19 minus 2, we get 17. 12 minus 3. Here 12 is the bigger number and we are going to make backward counting 3 steps. So after making 3 steps backward counting, we reach at number 9. Number 9 is the answer. 12 minus 3, we get 9. 16 minus 2. By making backward counting, we reach at 14. That is the answer. 11 minus 2. 11 is the bigger number. We are going to make 2 steps backward counting, reach at number 9. 14 minus 1. 14 is the bigger number and by making 1 step backward counting, we reach at number 13. It will be our answer or difference. 14 minus 1, we get 13. Here also we have the same sums. Solve this, remember the rules. 16 minus 6. Here 16 is the bigger number and we are going to make 6 steps backward counting. We reach at number 10 and it will be the answer. 18 minus 0. It is the rule of subtraction that whenever you are going to make subtraction of a 0 with any of the number, at the end you will get the same number as an answer. So 18 minus 0, we get number 18. 15 minus 15. It is also rule of subtraction that whenever you are going to make subtraction of the same number with given number, at the end you will get 0 as an answer. So 15 minus 15, we get 0, 0. 14 minus 1. By making backward counting 1 step, we reach at number 13 and it will be our answer. So 14 minus 1, we get number 13. 17 minus 16. So first of all, keep number 17 in your mind and make 16 steps backward counting. At the end you reach at number 1 and that will be the answer. So my dear students, this was a very quick recap of counting backward. I hope you all understand it as well as you have copied it in your notebook. Okay. Here we are going to learn about using your addition facts to subtract. What is this? How can we solve this? Let me explain it. Look, my dear students. Here is the sum of addition. 6 plus 7 is equal to 13. Let's prove it. This is 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 box, the pink color box, are in number of 6. Plus 7 means we have to add 7 more to it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. The green color box are in number of 7. Now let's see the answer is correct or not. Let's count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. Yes, 6 plus 7 is equal to 13. The answer is correct. So here we are going to prove it with the help of subtraction. Here we have the sum 13 minus 7. So as you all know that this strip is having 13 steps in it. We are going to subtract 7 out of that. And I told you before that this green color strip is having 7 steps in it. So 13 minus 7 means we have to cross out or remove 7 out of that. And here we have done it. Let's see, is it this addition is correct or not? Let's count the remaining steps. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So 13 minus 7 is equal to 6. Means one part is correct. Now let's check it on another way. 13 minus 6. So again I want to remind that this strip is having 13 steps in it. Here we have to subtract 6 out of that. And I told you before that this pink color strip is having 6 steps in it. So here we have removed or cross out 6. Let's see how many blocks are remaining. There remains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. 13 minus 6 is equal to 7. So we can say that this addition is correct. How we have proved it? With the help of subtraction. So we can say that this is addition factor subtract. Okay. Let's see some more. Here we have the sum 10 plus 5 is equal to 15. Let's see, is it correct or not? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Listen to me carefully, dear students, that this pink color blocks are in the number of 5. Let's count the purple color box. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Keep this thing in your mind that purple color blocks are in number of 10. So what is the total? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. 10 plus 5 is equal to 15. Now let's see the answer is correct or not. How? By cross-checking, making subtraction. 15 minus 5. 15 minus 5. So, I told you just that the pink color box are in number of 5. So, here we have crossed out or removed 5. There remains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. 15 minus 5 is equal to 10. So one step is correct. Let's check the another one. It is 15 minus 10. So just I told you that the purple color blocks are in number of 10. Let's check out the remaining blocks. It is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So 15 minus 10 we get now 5. So it is proved that this addition is correct. How we checked it? With the help of subtraction. First we subtract number 5 from 15. Afterwards we subtract number 10 from number 15. And we get the correct answer. So my dear students, this is called addition facts to subtraction. Now here we have the same exercise in the form of match the following. First match the addition fact to the subtraction one and then solve. Look, first one is done for us halfly. 5 plus 6 is equal to 11. So it is going to be matched with 11 minus 5. What will be the answer? It will be 6. 5 plus 6 is equal to 11 will match with 11 minus 5 is equal to 6. Next one is 9 plus 3 is equal to 12. So we have to find out the similar one in this column. Look, here we have 12 minus 9. 9 plus 3, 12 minus 9. So what will be the answer? 12 minus 9 will be 3. Let's match it. 9 plus 3 is equal to 12. When 12 minus 9 is equal to 3. I hope you all understand how to match these addition facts. Next one is 8 plus 5 is equal to 13. Now again move towards this column and see. Here we have 15 minus 8. But it is not going to match with this. We want number 13, 5 or 8. Here it is 13 minus 8. 13 minus 8. What will be the answer? 13 minus 8 we get number 5. Let's match it. 8 plus 5 is equal to 13. Going to match with 13 minus 8 is equal to 5. Next one is 10 plus 4 is equal to 14. Let's find out where it is. Yes, here it is 14 minus 10. 10 plus 4 is equal to 14. 14 minus 10 is equal to 4. Let's match it. The last one is 8 plus 7 is equal to 15. So here we have remains only 1, which is 15 minus 8. So 15 minus 8 will be 7. Let's match it. 8 minus 7 is equal to 15. Going to match with 15 minus 8 is equal to 7. So my dear students, I hope all the students understand this topic properly as well as they make copy in their book properly. Okay? Solve with the help of double addition facts. How can we solve this? Think in your mind. Look at the screen, my dear students, and tell me, what is this? How we can solve this? Do you have any ideas? We have 18 minus 9 is equal to dash because 9 plus 9 is equal to dash. 16 minus 8 is equal to dash because 8 plus 8 is equal to dash. Then we have 14 minus 7 is equal to dash because 7 plus 7 is equal to dash. Oh my God. What can we do now? Do you have any idea regarding this? Let me explain. First of all, we have to find out the answer of this question, which is 18 minus 9. So what will be the answer? 18 minus 9 we get a 9. Why? Because just we have understood the addition facts. 9 plus 9 is equal to 18. 18 minus 9 is equal to 9 because there comes 9 plus 9 is equal to 18. Each and everyone have to copy this work with me right now in your rough book. Write down it is 18 minus 9 is equal to 9 because 9 plus 9 is equal to 18. Okay? Next one is 16 minus 8. Oh, what will be the answer then? What comes there? 16 minus 8, we get number 8. How can this happen? Because, look, we have to compare these two. 8 plus 8, What will be the answer? Yes, obviously 8 plus 8 we get this number, which is number 16. The last one is 14 minus 7. Now tell me, my dear students, what will be the answer? 14 minus 7 we get 7. Why? How can we prove this? Because 7 plus 7, look, here we have 2 sevens. 7 plus 7, what will be the answer? It will be 14. So this is how we can solve this with the help of double addition facts. Okay, I hope you all understand this properly. Now get ready to write the tables. Table of 2. You all have to read and write with me, huh? 2 ones are 2. Write down, everyone. 2 twos are 4. 2 threes are 6. 2 fours are 8. 2 fives are 10. 2 sixes are 12. 2 sevens are 14. 2 eights are 16. 2 nines are 18. 2 tens are 20. So, my dear students, today first we make revision of previous lecture. Afterwards, we learn how to make balance about addition facts with the help of subtraction. First, we understand it with the examples. Afterwards, we make more practice with the help of exercise. So, and yes, of course, at last, we learned and write table of 2. And I hope now you all remembers tables of 1 to 7. Am I right? As we have almost completed the tables till 7. At the end, everyone note down the homework. Match the addition facts through subtraction one time in maths fair book. At your home, everyone, stay safe, stay happy, take care of yourself. We will meet in the next lecture with a new topic, some new exciting exercise. Till then, thank you very much and bye-bye, everyone.